Hi guys, it's KC here, and if you are still listening, looking for a reason to support the Park by the Posey movement to champion the rights of Charos, take a look, take a listen.
We don't have houses, we need houses. You afford expensive houses, but you want to block us from having a house.
Don't react, no one must react, don't react. No one must react.
Where do you stand up your business? This is my country here.
Uncle,
this is South Africa.
Uncle,
you can't come here and ask me where do you stay.
Uncle, leave it.
What is it about you? You come and ask me where do you stay?
Sorry. We're sorry.
Mina ngumZulu la, ikwa Zulu Natal la. You want me to take this feather? I will take it feather. This is not India.
Oh!
Hey, let's calm down. Come, Auntie Gita, come out from here. She come out. Wait. Calm down. Come, Auntie Gita. Leave, everyone, all people.
If you want to go,
no. Because from this time.
This project is going to happen whether you like it or not. Fuck you!
Okay, don't get emotional.
I am emotional. You are telling me what do I stay in my fucking country. How do you ask me where I stay? In my
fucking country.
This is South Africa and this is KZN. This is Japan. I stay here.
Now, let me warn you up front, there's some bad fucking language going to follow. So if you're one of those people that wears your elastic too tight, you'll fuck off now and don't watch the rest of this video. Logie Naidu, Viswan Reddy, Pops Ramprasad, Dr. Raj Govender, and all ANC ass lickers who are saying that our lobby group is bad for social cohesion, nation building, that we are further polarizing the black and Indian communities, please come to the front of the fucking class. What the fuck is going on here, eh, in this video? And this is not a fucking isolated case. It's been happening for years and it continues to happen. In fact, it's fucking getting worse. In the video, it's clear to see that the Charos, in the face of clear and present threat and danger, instead of reacting and making the situation worse, choose to back off, averting a conflict that could result in injury, death, or even spark a civil war. We are the ones who are trying our best to promote social cohesion and nation building, yet we are always fucking accused of hating on black people. This fucking bullshit needs to fucking stop, or else another 1949 is looming. Yes, 1949, a dark period in our history that is not spoken about, where the black community turned on the Indian community, maimed, murdered, tortured, and raped. Yes, atrocities that are never spoken of, because it shows black people to be the perpetrators. But 1949 will never be repeated in the same sense, because this time, Charos won't take this fucking shit lying down. You're poking a sleeping bear. Mr. Ramaphosa, our president, unless you want this shit to happen, unless you want it to happen, you will speak up about it. It happens under your watch. The proposed housing project in Newlands is a project of eTakwini Council. I wonder if the premier of the city or the city manager will intervene. Well, I think not, because maybe it's the plan they've always had to infiltrate the Indian areas to gain more votes so they don't lose to the DA and other parties, which is clear to see in Chatsworth and surrounding areas, Indian areas that is, where they infiltrate the Indian areas to gain more support. It's a fucking political ploy. Land is available elsewhere. Land is available everywhere. Why force it down the throat of an Indian community when they're obviously resisting it? Logie Naidu, Viswan Reddy, Dr. Raj Govender, and other Pops Ramprasad, who's shooting span on Facebook, dissing our movement. I challenge you to speak up about this. To challenge this narrative about go back to India. I propose that you canvass for it to be declared hate speech. That you get the powers that be to speak on behalf of the Indian people to declare that Indians belong here in SA and are fucking going nowhere. If you can't do that, I put it to you that you are a bunch of ass-sucking fucking wooders, done fuck all, prepared to do fuck all, but ready to criticize those wanting to take a stand. And what of the media, Post Newspaper, Rising Sun, Tabloid, East Coast Radio, Lotus FM, mediums that leverage off the Indian community? We, the Indian community, our listeners, your readers, are under attack. Are you prepared to raise these issues, these very issues that tears at the fabric of our society? Or are you too afraid? Or you don't care two fucking shits? Nice to fucking ask. I'm KC. I'm out. Don't die.